Betaflight 4.4 has been released and it comes with a brand new, cloud build system. This means that you can make customized firmware builds that include or exclude specific options. One of these options is, add OSD CraftName messages, to insert additional data into the CraftName parameter. There is already an option to get your radio link LQ and the warning messages into your DJI Goggles standard OSD, in other words without having to root your goggles. 4.4 comes with many other enhancements, but the possibility to get the LQ and the warnings messages and the new and improved GPS rescue features are the two most important to me. Always start by backing up your configuration by jumping into the CLI and typing diff, and then press enter. You can then save the output to a file. After choosing your flight controller make and model, you just put the parameters in the custom defines field and then click the load firmware button. The cloud build system will then create the customized firmware file for you. This takes about a minute or two. Then click flash firmware and wait for the flashing process to complete. Be sure to click the apply custom defaults once prompted and close the warning message about the accelerometer not being calibrated. Then go ahead and paste your diff from Betaflight 4.3 into the CLI. There will be some errors for some of the OSD parameters, but these are safe to ignore. Note: do not paste in a CLI diff from 4.2 or any other previous version. Only 4.3 is safe. I then applied the UAV Tech preset followed by the TBS Crossfire 150Hz and the 4.3 filter settings for clean build with RPM filtering. Then go to the CLI again and type set OSD CraftName messages equals on and press enter. Then type save and press enter. Then open the receiver tab and select the disabled option for RSSI channel. Then jump over to the OSD configuration and uncheck the RSSI value and make sure the CraftName is checked. Position the CraftName element where you want your LQ and warnings to be displayed and make sure you enable all the warnings that you wish to see, then finally click save. Your OSD in the DJI goggles should now show the LQ value. The element will toggle between the LQ value and the warning text if there is a warning. For reference, this is what it used to look like in 4.3 when using the RSSI value. It more or less always said 99 because I am using Crossfire on my Nazgul 5.
I could not foresee this.